the reality of it. Where you get the truth, where you get the real, where you can see all the things that's going on all around you. That's the reality of it. Where you get the truth, where you get the real, where you can see all the things that's going on all around you. That's the reality of it. Where you get the truth, where you get the real, where you can see all the things that's going on all around you.
And we tell it like it is.
Welcome back to That's the Reality of Us new season, and this year we're going to have some fantastic new guests, new topics. We're going to be bringing back young folks' time. Well, we're going to be highlighting young people's positive things that they're doing, their talent. We're also going to have the reality table, where we're going to be talking about different issues that affect us, our community, and the country. We're going to have music videos for local talent, so you can't miss this show this year because it's going to be fantastic. Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back.
So I switched my car insurance to State Farm. I saved $480. You know what that is?
Yeah, don't say it.
So you know what it is, right?
Yeah, hey, don't.
It's a lot of dough.
Switch and you could save $480 with State Farm.
It's a lot of dough.
See if Bryant Jenkins in Reisterstown can save you a lot of dough.
Get to a better state. State Farm.
You can look eye to eye at anyone when you're wearing the exquisite couture frames from Eye to Eye. Their beautiful exclusive eyewear is imported from all over the world, including London, Tokyo, Milan, and Paris. The specialists at Eye to Eye have the finest frames, great personalized service, and they do all the customizing in their in-house lab.
So come in and get the fashionable and unique eyewear at Eye to Eye.
And now, until the end of the month, get frames up to 50% off with the purchase of lenses.
Okay, we're back here with Dr. Richardson. Thank you again, Dr.
Real
Richardson.
Real nice to see you again.
Absolutely.
How you doing? Okay,
so
good.
We're here today at on location.
Yeah, we're in Glen Burnie, Maryland today.
Today.
Matter of fact, we're at ShopRite, and we're going to be talking about health.
Health. So you're going to be leading a seminar, correct?
I'll be leading a seminar. And just want to share with people some concepts and ideas, things that they can do to really take charge of their health and make a difference.
Okay. So basically, what's the seminar going to be structured or the topics?
Well, we're going to talk about the vision of having people be healthy nationwide, and Dr. Wallach's program in longevity, and what people can do to actually move their health from where they are to where they want it to be.
Okay, so let's get started on part one of the seminar. It's going to be done on two parts, correct?
Two parts, yeah. With one part, part one will be on this Sunday, and next Sunday we'll do part two.
Part two, so you got to make sure you tune in for both parts.
Right.
If you miss any part, you miss something that's going to be beneficial to your life.
And plus, they want to hear what this has done for them.
Exactly.
Some of the people that's going to share their testimonies in terms of how it's happened for them, what difference has it made in their life.
All right. Mm-hmm. So, let's go to the seminar.
Not too long ago, I had a young man coming to my office with every tooth in his mouth decayed, and I'm wondering what's happening. He's only about 27, 28 years old. All his teeth are gone, and I finally talking to him, he shared with what he does. He drinks Mountain Dews all day, every day. All his teeth are gone. He drank them at night. You wake up at night and take a sip. Keep on beside the bed. But when you think of the amount of sugar that's going into his body, not only is he going to lose his teeth, he's also going to lose his health. Because we're on that path. So when you think about it, for every molecule of sugar you eat, you need 54 molecules of magnesium just to neutralize that. Magnesium is one of the minerals that the body needs. Okay? So what do you prefer when you think about it? Do you prefer the Band-Aid? Or you prefer a cure? Okay? What do you prefer? So are you healing yourself long term, or are you just covering up the symptoms? I'll tell you something. I have people come into my office with bags of medicine. As a matter of fact, we used to, in taking medical issues, we write them down. The lists are often too long to write. We have to make copies of what they bring in just to put it in their record. That's how long the list is. So is it the Band-Aid or is it the cure? Now, let me share something with you as I get to the nutritional part. Let me share this with you. It's a disclaimer. And here's a disclaimer, because the Food and Drug Administration requires it. And the disclaimer is this. I can't sit here and tell you that nutrition is going to cure, heal, or prevent anything, because that's not what it does. What nutrition does is supports the body's ability to heal itself. I'm going to say that again. What nutrition does is supports the body's ability to heal itself. It doesn't heal anything. It doesn't prevent anything. It doesn't do any of that stuff. But if you put it in there, man, the body can do miraculous things. Okay, so I hope everybody got that. So, but the core of a good nutritional program is what Dr. Wallach called the 90 for life. The 90 for life provides the essential nutrients that the body need to help give the body those building blocks that are needed for optimal health and wellness, okay? Through 40 years of clinical research and discovery, confirm each nutritional deficiency linked to multiple health issues. Now, I'm going to give you an example of one, and it's readily known. Calcium, for example. There are over 143 diseases connected to calcium. Some of them you know about, things like osteoporosis. Bones start to break down, right? Even things like high blood pressure. All right, things like, there's just so many things. Even in the dental field, loss of the bone around the teeth, for example, can be a calcium problem. Things like kidney stone, things like heel spurs, those types of things can be calcium deficiency problems. See, each nutrient itself is linked to multiple diseases. As a matter of fact, Dr. Wallach says this. He says that for every nutrient, there are about 10 diseases on average linked to one each nutrient. So if there are 90 essential nutrients and you multiply that by 10, guess what that is? That's 900 different diseases. See, in veterinary medicine, by the way, in veterinary medicine, they can make claims for illness with nutrition, okay? In veterinary medicine, they've been able to wipe out over 900 diseases, and some of those diseases still plague people. I'll give you an example of one. There's something called an aneurysm. Anybody ever hear of aneurysm?
Yes.
Well, aneurysm happens when the vessel in your wall kind of balloon out. And when that vessel balloon out, it can burst. If it's in the head, that's caused a stroke, right? If it's in the chest, it causes a heart attack, but it balloons out. Well, back in the 60s, on a turkey farm, they found out that a lot of turkeys had died. When they did autopsy on the turkeys, they found they were dying of aneurysm. What they did, they put additional copper in their feed, and guess what happened? The next year, they didn't lose any turkeys because of aneurysm. So aneurysm can be associated with what? A copper deficiency. Now, don't go out and get copper by itself. It doesn't work, guys. That's only one building block. You cannot build a building with one building block. You need the 90 essential nutrients, okay? So that's the core of your longevity program. So the 90 essential nutrients is the core of the whole program. The reason that's important is this, because you have to give your body the fundamental building block. Once you give your body the building block, you can add things to that that will help in terms of things that you may want to target. Let me give you an example. If you are a diabetic, for example, you take the 90 for life, and Dr. Wallach calls it the secret sauce. You add Sweeties to it. If you add Sweeties to it, which is this little pedal right up here, if you add that to the 90 for life, that's called a healthy blood sugar pack. And what does it do? It helps give the body the key nutrients that it needs to help it to start to balance itself in terms of helping your body to bring the blood sugar under control. So your body can control it if you give it the building blocks it needs. Many other things as well. If you have a problem with, say, a prostate problem, use 90 for life and the ProstFX. That's going to support prostate health. Okay? Just to kind of give you an idea. So here's some health concerns that are often related to blood sugar imbalances. Now, if you look at this, it's kind of a large list, isn't it?
Yes.
Things like ADD, ADHD. Well, when you think about it, when our kids go to school in the morning, we give them the sugar cereals, right? And sugar make you climb the wall. As a matter of fact, I don't know if you know this or not, but sugar is also closely related to alcohol. Do you know that alcohol comes from sugar? And you know that when people get drunk sometime, and they do sometime, right? Some of them go in the corner and go to sleep, and some of them want to tear the building down. Well, kids are the same way. When they get the sugar, some of them just go to sleep and don't pay attention. And they say, well, they got ADD, attention deficit disorder. They're not paying attention. But some of them want to beat the other kids up. Okay? And that's what's happening there. So one of the solutions is you got to get the sugar out of their diet.
They say a pitcher or...
Coming up next is Young Folks Time.
Make those words stand out. You need the perfect frame.
That's when you call the professionals at Framing Place. The framers at Framing Place are perfectionists, and they will highlight the beauty of your painting or pictures to give it that perfect look
that will also complement your home decor. The highly trained professionals at Framing Place take meticulous care in every step of creating that perfect frame. For more information, go to framing.com.
At Liberty Animal Clinic, they know that your pet is a member of the family and you want to make sure they are healthy and receive excellent care. Their top veterinarians and staff will treat them like family and give the best care, medical treatment, and attention you can get anywhere. Liberty Animal Clinic provides these excellent services and they are open 6 days a week, including giving them a complete physical and office hours are by appointment, so please call. Let your extended family
join our family!
Coming up next is Young Folks Time.
Was very good, Scott. Where did you learn those cool moves?
Some of the moves I learned at ballet, and some I just made up.
Those moves that you made up and those moves that you learned at ballet, but I want to know, how old are you and what school did you attend?
I'm 7 and I go to Waverly Elementary School.
That's a very good school. And thank you for coming to this show.
Welcome.
And this has been its best Young Folks Time.
Hello, Marilyn. Join me in November for our new season of Best Reality of It.
With exciting guests and new kids segment, serious discussions on all topics, a spiritual message, health information with top doctors, plus music videos with local artists, and much more.
So don't miss That's Reality of It Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. on this TV. It's Javion, it's Granddaddy Baby. Yeah, Granddaddy Baby, it's Granddaddy Baby.
I used to be on crack cocaine.
I used to be on heroin.
I used to be on heroin.
I used to be on pills.
And now we're not.
My name is Pamela Dukes. I used to be an addict. Now I'm the owner of By Grace Counseling Services, where we help addicts become productive members of society.
By Grace Counseling Services is a certified methadone clinic, and they can help you live a drug-free life. Don't fight those demons alone. Call 443-831-0191. Call now.
Okay, we're back, and I'm here with my favorite doctor, sometimes. Except when I get those prostate exams, I don't like you very much.
That's okay, I understand.
You understand? Dr. Sigmund from Chesapeake Urology, thank you again for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me back.
You know, we had emails coming about the, in fact, you emailed me back about, bladder cancer.
Yes.
So I want to get into some of that aspect of, because it's becoming like a fear out there for the bladder cancer, because I haven't really heard a lot about bladder cancer, but I know that a very good friend of mine just passed with bladder cancer. And so I'm kind of more into it than I would have normally been.
Sure.
So let's start with what is bladder cancer?
Well, you know, bladder cancer is something that we have to deal with fairly often. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it gets overshadowed by prostate cancer because you hear a lot more about prostate cancer in the media and people are much more familiar with it. But as urologists, you know, bladder cancer is really the number two cancer that we deal with. Obviously, you have a urinary bladder that holds urine and drains when people want it to drain. Unfortunately, cancer can develop in the bladder, and really the biggest risk factors for bladder cancer are people who smoke or people who are exposed to various toxic substances or chemicals or certain dyes that they might work with in their occupation.
Okay, what type of chemicals or toxic fumes that would cause?
Well, there's something called aniline dyes in certain rubbers that if people work with, and they're exposed to that. But really, the biggest risk factor is smoking. And it's really amazing to me. In my practice, one of the first people I diagnosed with a very bad bladder cancer, he presented to the hospital with a lot of blood in the urine. And he was a smoker for a long time. And he could have understood getting lung cancer, but he had no idea that his smoking put him at risk for bladder cancer. It was hard for him to understand. So that's another reason that people should quit smoking, and we try to get the word out with regard to that.
Man, I had no idea that smoking caused that many different issues. So it also not only lung cancer, but can also cause bladder cancer.
It certainly can.
And now when you said certain types of, this is going to sound crude, but you say certain types of rubber. Do you mean rubber that men use for sex?
Oh, no, not that type of rubber, but rubbers that are used industrially.
Okay.
Types
we'll
of things.
We'll clear that up.
No, absolutely. Yeah.
Can you be saying, what? I can't.
Yeah, condoms, no association with that, but other types of the rubber chemicals that are out there.
What are the symptoms?
Well, usually people present with blood in the urine. And they
blood that's visible or?
Either blood that's visible or microscopic blood. We see a lot of people who come to me with a diagnosis of microscopic hematuria. And what that means is when we do the urine dipsticks and look under the microscope, we see red blood cells in the urine, and that warrants evaluation. And what we do for those folks, we do a CAT scan to take a look at their kidneys, their urine tubes, and their bladder. And we also look in their bladder with a little lighted telescope, similar to colonoscopy. Right. We call it cystoscopy.
Okay.
And that's how we make the diagnosis of bladder cancer.
Now, I came to you and I had an ultrasound.
Yes.
Is that as effective as the CAT scan? Because they did one for my kidneys and my back. And also for, I think, my bladder?
Yes. So often we use an ultrasound to take a look at the kidneys, look for kidney stones, follow people. We'll do an ultrasound of the bladder to see how well people are emptying their bladder, to possibly look at the prostate. But when people have blood in the urine, the recommendation is to do a CAT scan because it's a more specific test to look for abnormalities when people have blood in the urine. Really, to find bladder cancer, you have to look in the bladder. Most x-rays won't necessarily find bladder cancer unless it's very large, but small bladder cancers we find by looking in the bladder.
When you say looking in the bladder,
That's with the little lighted telescope.
Goes where?
Well, it's got to get to the bladder somewhere, so we go right down the channel, the urethra.
where people pee through. For men, we go through the penis, through the urethra. For women, we go right through their urethras into the bladder.
Women can have bladder cancer.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, okay, okay. All right, so,
It's not the most pleasant test for most people. It's very tolerable. It's about a 3-minute test. We use a little numbing jelly, and usually 3 minutes later, we know what's going on.
Would you like to make $300 to over $3,000 a week on your own time? Then call Odyssey Production and join their marketing team by selling TV advertisements. And you can get paid each day. For more information, go to the employment section on our website or call 443-394-7333.
I used to be on crack cocaine.
I used to be on heroin.
I used to be on heroin.
I used to be on pills.
And now we're not.
My name is Pamela Dukes. I used to be an addict. Now I'm the owner of By Grace Counseling Services, where we help addicts become productive members of society.
By Grace Counseling Services is a certified methadone clinic, and they can help you live a drug-free life. Don't fight those demons alone. Call 443-831-0191. Call now.
I am Dr. Annie at RideWeight Center. I know you've seen a lot of these big name companies on TV promising to help you lose weight and charging you hundreds of dollars with long-term contracts.
I can assure you that we all use similar products that help you lose weight.
The only difference is they charge hundreds of dollars more. For years, RideWeight has helped thousands of people get to their desired weight, including me. Call and schedule a free evaluation.
Thank you, everyone, for joining me for What's Up with Pastor N, where you all know that something is always up with God because he's always doing something in our lives. I just want to pray God's blessings over you all. And again, thank you all for joining me for this show. On today, we want to talk a little bit about the parents' responsibility in raising their children to what they want them to be. I feel like a lot of parents are appalled by their children's behavior, and they're looking around wondering why their children have developed the way they are. Some of them even blame society, but there are a lot of us that don't take the time to look at ourselves and say, maybe I'm the reason why my child is the way they are. The Bible says in Proverbs 22:6, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Now, that scripture, even though it's scripture, can actually have negative implications, because depending on how you raise up your child, that's going to be the way they should go. Yes, with this scripture, we're talking about raising our children up in a godly manner. But if you raise your child up in a ghetto manner, if you raise your child up with no manners at all, with no responsibility, all types of illicit behaviors, things that you saw growing up, then you have to imagine that your child is going to grow that way as well. Now, I think one of the other problems that we have is a lot of our children aren't even being raised. So we're supposed to raise up our children. We're supposed to grow our children, which means that our children have a nature within them where they want to be guided and they want to be shown direction. But when that's not being fulfilled, all they're going to do is try to raise themselves and find their own direction. And then we get mad at them for trying to be grown. We say they're acting out, but we haven't given them the keys to act properly. Notice what the Bible says in Deuteronomy 6, 4-9. It says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. These commandments that I give to you today are to be on your hearts." He's talking to adults. But then watch what it says. "Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road and when you lie down." Essentially, he's telling the children, you have to have this love for God in your hearts first. Once you've mastered this, once you have this, then you're supposed to teach this to your children. You're supposed to teach God's commands and his statutes to your children. And parents, if you don't love God, you can't show your children the love of God. And the reality is, when children are trying to learn about who this invisible God is that they haven't seen, or we're trying to get our children to get on the right path, stop stealing, stop killing, stop doing this, if we're trying to give them a model of God to see, the best model that they're going to see is in their parents. Sometimes we're the only God that they see for a long time. Now, we may be praying for them, but at some point, we want them to get to the point where they say, I want to receive Jesus Christ for myself. So we can't be so hard on our children without being hard on ourselves if we're not fulfilling our responsibility. You may be saying, well, that scripture doesn't apply to me really because I'm not saved yet. I'm going to tell you what, the only saving grace that you have for your children to turning their life around, for them to be transformed and be the child that you want them to be, is you coming into the knowledge of knowing Jesus for yourself and then learning his commandments and his laws and teaching them to your children. So we have a responsibility, parents. We can lock our children up, but that's not going to change a thing. We can spank them and we should, but that's not necessarily going to change a thing. They need to see God in their home. They need to see God reflected, God practiced. They need to see God's love coming out of those parents so that it transfers down to the children. Well, I don't think we need to talk about this anymore. I think it's time for us to, some of us probably need to go somewhere and repent and say sorry. And we need to go to our children and cuddle them and care for them and tell them sorry for the names that we call them and sorry for not showing them a better example of what Christ looks like. And let's get back to basics and do what we need to do. This is Pastor Ian Edwards. I thank you for joining me on today. Make sure you join us for services at Winning Souls Evangelistic Church. That's at 2322 Mountain Road in Pasadena, Maryland, 21122. That's at 10 a.m. We have Bible studies on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. And if you want to send a donation to keep us on the air, it's at P.O. Box 112, Odenton, Maryland, 21113.
Are your teeth yellow and stained? Stop hiding that smile and call Always Love Your Smile. Change that dull yellow smile to a beautiful white smile you'll love. Using their state-of-the-art teeth whitening technique, they guarantee to change smiles like these to smiles like these in one visit with lasting results. So if you want a smile you can be proud of, call Always Love Your Smile for a free teeth whitening consultation and visit their website or social media.
Time to hit the trails on a bike from the Pikesville Bicycle Shop. They have all makes and models for all ages and sizes, and they'll service your bike and customize it to fit your needs. So for the very best variety of bikes, the best service and price, come to Pikesville Bicycle Shop or call 410-602-BIKE and take advantage of our special deals.
I love my Hero.
If you're looking for a primary care doctor that truly puts patients first, then call Windsor Medical Center, where you'll get excellent care from award-winning Dr. Nguyen Yu. Windsor Medical Center is equipped to diagnose many health issues, including heart, lungs, and diabetes.
We really care
about you
at the Windsor Medical Center.
Call 410-265-7742.
Well, I hope you enjoyed it because we're going to have this type of thing every Sunday. New topics, new people, young folks' time, and videos. So make sure you tune in every Sunday because you're not going to want to miss anything that we have on the show. So if it's all good, it's all God. So be blessed with God first because through Him, all things are possible. See you next Sunday.